All right, welcome tonight to our elementary program. I think you're going to really enjoy it, as you've already heard. I think that as you listen tonight, I hope you can hear. But as you have already seen, it's kind of hard to hear. The Lord is providing for us an opportunity to be able to put a new sound system in the gymnasium. Barry Heidi passed away not long ago, and one of his wishes was that we were able to put a new sound system in. And praise the Lord, we just got about $11,000 in up to this time. And we praise the Lord for that. Still doesn't mean you don't have the opportunity to give. We have some envelopes in the bag if you'd like to give toward it. I talked to a company in Columbus, said about $15,000 to do a digital sound system in here. And so we are just praying the Lord will open that door. I know it's going to benefit, and we appreciate you praying about that, asking the Lord what he would have you do about that. Also, the drama department invites you to our spring play, Trouble in Paradise Junction, on Friday, April 29th, and Saturday, April 30th. There's flyers back there as you go out this evening. We're also seeking sponsors for the play. We'll advertise your business that night, and in our program, individuals are welcome also to sponsor, as well as you may remain anonymous. See Mrs. Fitch or pick up a flyer tonight. So hope that you do that. Looking forward to what God has for us. Can I just say thank you for allowing your students to come to Fayette Christian School? We're praying that the Lord would continue this ministry in a mighty way, even greater than it ever has been. One note, I hope you pray for the backpack bill that is in our state legislature right now, which would give parents the opportunity to send their kids wherever they want to, and then the parents would get that tax break. And so you pray about that the Lord would bless that. But we thank you for tonight, and let's have a word of prayer, and then the program will continue, all right? Father, thank you so much for your love to us. We thank you for this opportunity that we can see these young people, Lord, perform for your honor and your glory. Father, may we realize that in all that we do, we are yours, and that we have that desire to glorify your name in word and in deed and in conversation. Thank you for these children. Pray that you would bless now in this program. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Camping trip at my age.
Okay, kids, take a seat. Here we go.
Okay.
Sing when you were younger?
That's a good question. Let me see. Oh, I know one.
Why don't you sing it for us? Kids, wouldn't you like to hear Mrs. Nelson sing?
Yes. We have to.
Well, then, all right, I'll sing. Standing on the promises of Christ my King. Did we hit something?
Are we there yet?
Is the bus busted?
Oh, my.
Everyone just stay calm. I'm going to take a look out under the hood.
Oh my, okay, what do we do in a breakdown situation? Oh, here it is. Number one, remain calm. Okay, I'm calm. Number two, have the children remain seated. Children, please stay seated.
We are sitting, Mrs. Nelson.
Oh yes, I see that now. Okay, well, next.
Well, kids, looks like we're gonna be staying here for a while. Busted radiator hose.
I know.
We all want to get to Camp Wallaballa sooner rather than later. But we're going to have to make the most of it, because there's no cell coverage in this valley.
Oh my, okay, what do we do in a breakdown situation? I know I've seen it in here somewhere.
Everyone just get out, and we'll figure out a plan. If anyone sees a car, flag it down.
Car? We haven't seen another car in hours. Come on, kids, everybody off.
Dustin, what are we gonna do? It'll be dark soon, and I can't seem to locate my bus breakdown procedures page.
Mrs. Nelson, just calm down. We're not out here alone. The Lord will watch over us.
Thank you.
into joy.
Good. Anything is better than just standing around here.
What is it? What's the plan?
So, we're going to divide up into three groups. One group will stay here with me, and the other two go with Mr. Mike and Miss Linda.
I want to go with Miss Linda.
I'll go with Mr. Mike.
Okay. Hold on. Look at the color of your shirts. Those are the groups you'll be in. Miss Linda, you take the yellow group. Muscular Mr. Mike, Miss Linda, you take the red group. Muscular Mr. Mike takes the yellow group, and the green group will stay here with me. So, do you guys want to know the plan?
Of course.
Yes. Tell us.
So you'll hike up those two hills to try and find cell coverage. I'll give each group an air horn. Three short blasts on SOS. One long blast meaning that you found cell coverage and we'll all meet back here. Everyone got it?
I thought we were a lot of electronic devices.
That's true. You're not, but sponsors can. Miss Linda, you have yours?
Wouldn't be without it. Okay, girls, let's go.
Wait just a minute. According to my hiking for help procedures, you'll need a medical kit. Here, let me get one for you. Well, that's not what I need. Oh, here they are. There, you take that.
Oh, I'm so glad I'll be staying with you, Dustin.
Me too, Mrs. Nelson. Me too. Okay, Mr. Mike, you take that hill. Miss Linda, you go over there.
Come on, Mr. Mike. This is going to be fun.
Okay, guys. I'm coming. See you later. Here, Chris. You're in charge of the air horn.
Great.
On second thought, I'll take the horn.
Oh no, what are we gonna do?
Let's just walk through the water.
Oh, but my feet will get wet and my other pair of shoes is on the bus.
Your shoes will dry.
I don't want to. I'm sick of this hiking. Why did our bus have to break down?
Colette, it'll be okay. Let's just take off our shoes and cross this little creek.
Little creek? It's a raging river. I can't even see the white caps.
Those aren't white caps. Those are blossoms from a tree.
Oh.
Come on, girls. Let's take our shoes off. I think if we can get across this little creek right up there, we can get to a place where my phone will work.
I can't. I just can't. Oh, my toes are going to get in that slimy mud. I know I should have never come to camp.
Come on, Colette. You can do this. Remember that scripture verse we learned at VBS?
No.
Yes, you do. We all recited it together.
I just can't think of anything right now. And look at all the bugs and spiders. And what about snakes?
Be not afraid, be not afraid, be not afraid.
the groups have been out for over an hour. It seems like we would have heard something by now.
I think we'll hear something soon. Oh, hey guys, good work. It's always good to be prepared. That'll make a nice fire if we need one.
I hope it's enough. I'm done.
Me too.
It's okay. Take a load off.
Here, I'll get you some reading material.
How about a snack instead?
Oh yes, a snack is a good idea.
So what are we gonna do now?
Well, we could sing a song.
I really wish I had my iPod right now. I could really go for some tunes.
Actually, singing a song could be more fun than listening to one, because if you sing it, it becomes a part of you.
So, what do you want to sing?
I don't know any cool songs.
I'll make it easy. We'll start, and they'll echo. I'm glad to hear that, because those words are really important to me. That's actually my life promise scripture.
What's a life promise scripture?
A life promise scripture is a promise from God for your whole life. I want you each to choose one at camp.
Why?
Because a life promise scripture can be important through your whole life. And we'll learn more about it at camp.
That sounds hard.
It's really not. You'll choose one that you want to memorize, and then you can pray about it. And don't worry, God will help you remember it.
I like the one we just sang. I might make it mine.
That's a good one. Are we there yet?
We haven't been gone that long.
I'm hungry.
Well, lucky for you, I have some power bars in my backpack.
This trail isn't very good. How do we know where to go?
Well, I've been on lots of hikes, and I know the signs. I've got a compass on my watch because I was hoping to hike at Camp Wallaballa. Looks like God provided one sooner than I thought.
I just wish we knew where we were going.
Just hike, man, no worries.
I just don't have a plan.
We do have a plan. We're hiking until we get salt covers and I get the bloody air horn.
We've been hiking for 30 minutes. When do we get back to the bus? When is lunch? If I knew we were hiking, I would have brought my pen light, my compass, and my pocket knife.
Okay, guys, let's just take a break here. Here, have some power bars and some water. Just chill. It's going to be okay.
It's just that.
Sometimes things happen that we can't anticipate, but that doesn't mean they're not part of God's plan. God knew we were going to break down. God knows we need a place to camp safe and sound. He's going to guide us. He has a plan, and this time together is part of it. I think he wants us to ask his guidance and ask him to increase our trust in him. You know what? I let you down.
What?
We should have prayed before we set out on the trail. Why don't we pray right now? Father, thank you for keeping us safe this far, and thank you for giving us our health and means to go to Camp Wallaballa. Father, we're stuck right here and we need your help. Will you help guide us to find someone to help us get the bus fixed? Help us to sense your spirit and increase our trust in you. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks, Giles. I guess we needed that.
Man, what we need is a GPS.
If we had one, missing nothing might take it with us. Now electronic devices.
Guys, we do have a GPS. It's God's promise source. He's always ready to give direction. We just need to listen to him. Come on, you know I'm thinking there might be salt covers right over that hill.
To keep America's action and secure. a plan. I'll give Abby my phone, and she'll get on my back, and I'll hold her in place so she can make the call, okay?
Let's do it!
Any coverage?
2 bars. Can't get through, though.
Okay, we're making progress. Let's move to the right.
Still 2 bars.
Okay, let's go the other way.
3 bars? Move a little more? Okay, okay. 5 bars.
Okay, call.
Hello? Camp Wallaballa. Can you hear me now? Awesome!
Did you hear that? We're saved.
That's great.
I'm letting them know we heard them.
Okay, settle down. I know you're all excited, but I have a feeling it's gonna be a while before the other group arrives and the camp bus gets here. Mrs. Nelson, could you?
Already on it, Dustin. Bug spray for everyone.
Actually, Mrs. Nelson, I was thinking hydration.
Oh yes, water. That's a good idea.
So it's gonna be a while before the camp bus arrives. So we might as well take a snooze.
Snooze? Is there just something we can do?
Well, you could think about God.
Why is everything a God thing with you, Mr. Dustin?
Because I want everyone to know about him so that they don't have to be afraid of him. They'll live a more full life.
So how do you get to know Jesus?
It's as easy as ABC. A, you admit you're a sinner. You've done bad things. B, believe that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, and that he died on the cross. And C, confess that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, and friend.
That's it? That's all you have to do?
It really is. If you want to know Jesus, I can help you talk to him and ask him into your life.
Can we talk more about this later?
Sure. I'm going to go get something off the bus. I'll be right back.
There's a song that keeps going in my head and I can't get it out.
What song is it, Taylor?
I don't remember the name.
Well, why don't you sing it for us?
Giving all the breath of life through our creation.
guys all singing a song earlier. Did you know that that song's actually a promise of God?
Weird. We sing a promise of God in our group. So did we.
It looks like God's up to something. I want us all to think about God's promises this week. But it looks like he's already given us a new understanding of his word. Well, let's read these verses together to see how God guided his people. No, just to see all God's promises. Since the beginning of creation, God has made promises with his people, and not one has failed. Let's read these verses to show how God's promises moved and influenced the people in their lives. Noah.
I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be a sign between me and the old.
Abraham. Isaac.
Stay in this land for a while, and I will be with you and will bless you.
Jacob.
I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go. I'll bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I've done what I've promised you.
Moses.
I will be with you.
Caleb and Joshua. David.
I call to the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, and I shall be safe from all enemies.
Solomon.
The Lord has kept this promise that he made, and now I have succeeded my father David, and now I sit on the throne of Israel.
Jehoshaphat.
Do not be afraid or discouraged of this vast army, for the battle is not yours, but God's.
Jeremiah. Ezra and Nehemiah.
You are a forgiving God, gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and abounding in love.
Daniel.
For those who are wise will shine like the brightness of the heavens, and those who lead many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever.
Isaiah.
When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you.
Ezekiel. Nahum.
The Lord is good and refuge in times of trouble. He cares for those who trust in him.
Habakkuk.
The sovereign Lord, he is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. He enables me to go on the heights.
Zechariah.
For I am coming and I will live among you, declares the Lord.
Malachi.
Return to me and I will return to you, says the Lord Almighty.
Every promise from the Lord has been fulfilled. Not one has failed. Have you claimed his promises? The greatest promise of God is found in a child, Jesus. Because in him, we find God's ultimate promise, salvation.
For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. God, I think that promise means you love me. I really don't understand it at all, but I want you in my life. Amen. Thank you.
John 3:16 is a good life promise scripture for you. But there's so many other promises that God has made, that, and you can start claiming them. Promises to give you a future and a hope.
Dustin, my brother's been really bad. He's done some really bad things lately. He's mean to Mom, and yesterday he went to the hospital because he does drugs.
I'm sorry to hear that, Taylor.
Do you think God could forgive him too? He's been really bad.
Yes, I think God can forgive him. Sometimes God finds us when we're in a deep, dark spot. And sometimes that's when we see him most. Maybe you can be that light that teaches Jesus Christ to your brother.
Me? Really?
You, really. We have all week to talk about it.
Listen, do you hear that? The bus!
Yay!
Yay!
Okay, kids, pack up. It's time to go. And don't leave food on the bus.
That's okay. You've helped remind me that all the answers aren't on that in that book.
Hey, Dustin, are we there yet?
Almost, Taylor. Almost.
Here we go to Camp Wallaballa. We're gonna
Thank you so much for coming tonight. I hope that you understood, and I'm sure you did, the promises of God are true. The greatest promise that he has is the promise of his son, Jesus Christ, who says, I will never leave thee, nor will I forsake thee. May as we go from this place, we realize that God is near. God is there. There are many difficulties in life, but God is there for you. And I hope that as you go from this place, that you will glorify the God of heaven by giving him your heart. Let's stand. We'll have a closing word of prayer, and then you'll be dismissed. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for who you are. We thank you for our parents, our grandparents. Lord, we thank you for these children that are a heritage unto the Lord to these parents. And Lord, as we have heard tonight, your promise.